Hi everyone, today we are going to be talking about a terrific solo from LeRoi Moore on Dave Matthews Band's tune, Stay. This solo has always stood out to me because it starts out like a solo, albeit one that musically thumbs its nose at the listener. You'll hear what I mean when it goes, yeah, 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 yeah. It's kind of clever. And then it gets absorbed into the rhythmic texture while totally driving the tune forward toward the end. It's 2 minutes long, and it is a great practice in placing sixteenths in a funk setting. It's great practice for articulation variation and overall vibe. I absolutely loved learning it, but first, who's LeRoi Moore? Well, LeRoi Moore was a saxophonist who started his career in Virginia, mostly as a jazz player in small bands. And like nearly all of us, Moore's day job was not in music. In his case, he worked in the laundry room of a hospital. But he played gigs on nights and weekends in and around Virginia. So it was at one of these jazz gigs where he connected with Dave Matthews shortly after Matthews arrived from South Africa. I had no idea that Dave Matthews is from South Africa. Well, anyway, Matthews was a bartender at that bar where Moore was playing, and soon started inviting Moore to sessions where Matthews was working on early versions of his first tunes. So Moore becomes one of the three founding members of the Dave Matthews Band and contributes enormously to its unique sound until his untimely death in 2008. You can hear Moore's playing mature throughout the band's first three albums, and he continued to add instruments to his toolbox each album. So on the first record, which is called Under the Table and Dreaming, he plays only soprano and tenor sax. On the second album, called Crash, he added Barry Sax in response to producer Steve Lillywhite's quest for something more meaty. In fact, Barry is the instrument most featured on the record, and since Crash was my first introduction to Dave Matthews Band in 1996, I actually thought Moore was primarily a Barry player. Little did I know that he had to borrow the instrument for the sessions. Finally, on the third album, Before These Crowded Streets, LeRoi added bass clarinet, which felt like a personal favor to me. And it's this third record that the tune Stay comes from. This is by far my favorite track on the album, and I think it's my favorite Moore solo of any album. It's certainly the one I come back to the most often. Now, like I said earlier, I want you to hear how on this solo, LeRoi Moore turns the tenor sax basically into a rhythm guitar. Just listen to how dry his staccatos are. This is something you never see and you never hear in classical music, staccatos this dry. It's something I've been able to add to my own bag of tricks, which by the way is the whole point of doing this sort of critical listening, transcription, imitation, and practice. So, on Stay, Moore shows off just how much of an influence James Brown's sax player Maceo Parker was. Now, Parker was famous for playing these funky percussive staccato jabs or repetitive short licks in James Brown's tune. I mean, just listen to this live solo from 1968 at the Boston Garden. By the way, this concert at Boston Garden was the day after Martin Luther King was murdered, and it's something that you need to see. If you can watch the whole concert go down, there's a part where basically the audience starts to come up on the stage, and the police officers from Boston, who are primarily and predominantly white, come up and try to push the people who are trying to dance on stage with James Brown off the stage, and James Brown just takes total control of the situation, and he basically averts a complete riot in Boston. I mean, all of the emotion around King's murder and everything, James Brown just sort of, just watch this guy take control. It's actually kind of an incredible video to watch. All right, so with that, let me play this amazing solo. Listen to how the tenor sax solo and Moore obviously playing this solo adds so much momentum and groove to the track that it just propels to the very last note of the tune, which is played, of course, by LeRoi Moore. Stay, stay, stay.